just have a look that we have studied that cantilever method is also known as proportional column axial stress. Now the previous method called as portal method, in which column shear was proportional to it. Now here we'll be taking care of axial stress. Also, one thing need to keep in mind that axial stress in all the column at any level is proportional to the distance of centroid of the cross section of all the columns at that level. So these two thing need to be keep in mind before starting with the example. Now let's see how it works. Analyze the building frame shown in figure by cantilever method and draw SFD, BFD and axial force diagram. So this is my given figure. The height is also different and width of the bay are also different. So as it said that it works on the centroidal axis of the particular column. So let's have a look how to find out this centroidal axis. So this is the thing which we have already studied in the subject called MOS. So how to find out the say centroidal axis. So the vertical centroidal axis of the frame, let's say all the column have the same cross section area. Right now here the area of the column is not mentioned. So if not mentioned, then we have to take A as well. And probably all the most of the case the area of the column will be similar. So here right now I am considering all the columns having cross sectional area as A. Now let the x bar distance of the vertical centroidal axis of the frame from left hand side. So this is my left hand side of the extreme left of the frame. Now here I am considering the centroidal axis. Centroidal axis is nothing but the center of the entire frame. As we can see that this is an 8 meter and this is a 6 meter. So somewhere over here the centroidal axis would come. So the formula is nothing but x bar equals to, if I consider this column frame, so from here the distance is 0 because my for this column, if I am standing over here, so the distance will be 0. So A multiplied by 0. For this column, if I am standing over here, so A multiplied by 6. And for this column, the distance is 8 plus 6 is 14, so A multiplied by 14. So A multiplied by 0 plus A into 6 plus A into 14 divided by 3A, because there are 3 number of columns. So it is coming out to be a 20A divided by 3A equals to 6.67. So my centroidal axis will be more than 6, somewhere here 6.67. So this is my centroidal axis. Now reference to this, we will to find out the axial stress of the columns. So first of all, we need to find out this inertia. We will be using that equation m by I equals to f by y equals to e by r. So we will be taking care of it. So for that I need I. So moment of inertia I at centroidal axis. So Ig is equals to, if I am considering this column as here, so the distance is 6.67. So A multiplied by 6.67 square plus A multiplied by 0.67 square plus this column is 8 minus 0.67. It is nothing but 7.33. So A multiplied by 7.33 is the whole. So I will be getting my moment of inertia as Ig equals to 98.67 A. Right now my A is common for all. So step 3 is overturning moment at midpoint of the column. So for story 2, this is my story 2. If I am standing on the midpoint of the column, the bending moment will be this 40 kN load multiplied by distance half of 4 is nothing but 2. So 40 multiplied by 2 is nothing but 80 kN into meter, which is going clockwise direction. So this is my overturning moment for story 2 at this point. For story 1, over here there are two forces. The forces of 40 will be 40 multiplied by the whole distance this plus half of distance this. We need to calculate over here half of this. So half of this is nothing but 3. So 3 plus 4 is 7. 40 multiplied by 7 plus 80 multiplied by 3. So I will be getting 520 kN into meter. So we will be using these 3 in the next step. So next step is column axial force, which is the prime importance for this method. So the note has to be taken in mind that the windward column left of the centroidal axis are subjected to tensile force, while the leeward columns are subjected to the compressive force. What it says, windward, in the sense it is considering this load as a wind load. So if this load is coming from this direction, So look, if this is my centroidal axis, then what will happen due to this load, this will try to overturn like this. So what will happen, this column will experience tensile force, also this column will experience tensile force, because from the reference to the centroidal axis, it is coming out to like this, it is swaying like this. So in this particular column, there is a tensile force, and this column will experience the compressive force because it is compressed. This and this column will experience the tensile force. So this thing need to be keep in mind that windward side on the central left hand side of the axis, tensile force. So whatever the column which is left side of the central axis will experience the tensile force, and on the right hand side will experience the compressive force. So in the story 2, we need to find out stress in column AD. So this is my column AD. We need to find out stress over here. So I am taking bending stress formula as F by Y equals to M by I. So I will be finding out F equals to M into Y upon I. So I we have already found out over here. M for story 2, I have got 80 kN into meter. And remaining this Y distance. So for this AD column, the distance is 6.67 because it is 6.67 meter away from the centroidal axis. So my Y distance is nothing but this much distance, 6.67 over here shown. So by placing all the values, we can find out the F equals to 5.41 upon A, as still our A is common. So to find out force, so we know the formula that stress is equal to load upon area. So right now we are having stress, so we need to find out force. So load equals to nothing but stress multiplied by area. So my stress is 5.41 upon A multiplied by area. We have assumed entire frame column having the area as A. So this A and A will be directly cancelled out, and we will be getting the force as 5.41 kN. So this is my force in column AD as 5.41. So I have got the axial force for this column. Now as we have discussed earlier that this will experience the tensile force. So that's why here I have written T as a tensile. Now likewise this, we will be finding out stress in column BE and CF. So look, where is BE, which is over here, and CF is over here. Now this is all for story 2, so my moment will be same as AT. My value of I will also remain the same. Now just the change will be in this distance of Y. Now look here, this is 0.67 meter away and this column is 7.33 meter away. So the Y value will be 0.67 and 7.33 respectively. So with the help of that, we can find out each respective stress, and multiply by area, we can find out the force. Now note down that these two are on the left hand side of the leeward side, or say centroidal axis. So these two are in tension, and the CF column is on the right hand side, so it will be in compression. Similarly to this, we can find out the value for story 1 column, which is column DG, EH and FI. Just similar to this, the formula will be same, the moment will only change, which is earlier was 80 for story 1 and for story 2 is 520. So just the moment has been changed, remaining values are similar, you can see over here. So respect to that, we can find out the forces in each of the column. So with the help of this, I have found out the axial force in the particular column. Now from now onwards, all the steps are way much similar to the previous sum called as portal method. So right now the change is just over here. In the previous sum of portal method, so we have studied using that equation of Q, 2Q, 2Q and Q. For intermediate column it is 2Q and for exterior column it was Q. Now here with the help of stress, we have found out axial force. Now look what I did. I have just placed the value of axial forces in the particular column. Look, this is 5.41, 0.54 and 5.94. Similarly, this R35, 3.5 and 38. 35, 3.5 and 38. So look, the thing is, these are in tension, these are also in tension, and this is in compression. Now, with the help of this column axial force, we can find out beam shear, because this will help find out the shear of the beam. So consider each joint as a free body diagram and apply condition summation of B equals to 0. So first of all is joint A. So at joint A, I have these two members, A to D and A to B. We have to find out beam shear, which is QAB. And I have already earlier found out this column axial force, which is coming out to be 5.41. So I am considering upward as a positive and downward as a negative. So QAB minus 5.41 equals to 0. So QAB is nothing but 5.41 kN. So this is my, say, shear, beam shear. Similarly, next joint I have considered as a joint B. So members are B2A, B2C and B2E. This is, we have recently found out this 5.41. If this is upward, then equal and opposite need to be applied, which we have provided over here. So with the help of it, we can find out QBC. So summation of joint at B, vertical forces are 0. So QBC is upward, minus 5.41 and 0.543. So with the help of this, we can find out QBC. Similarly, for joint D, as we have completed for upper beam, now for the story one beam. So if joint D has been considered, so this one member is D2A and D2G and D2E. Similarly, we can find out QDE, and same way we can find out the force in this EF member also. So we have found out beam shear. Now with the help of beam shear, we can find out beam moments. So step 6 is nothing but beam moments. So this step is also similar to the previous session stuff called Hodel method. So to find out this moment, what we will be doing, load into half of the distance. So for MAB member, for AB member, moment at MAB and MBA will be similar because the forces are similar. So if I'm standing over here, this force is 5.41 and distance is 6. So half of 6 is nothing but 3. So 5.41 multiplied by 3 is nothing but 16.23 kN to it. If I'm standing on B point, then this MBA moment will be 5.41 into this, which is also going in an anti-clockwise direction. So I have considered anti-clockwise as the positive. So for MBC and MCB, 5.93 multiplied by 4. So here distance will be 4, here distance will be 3, and here distance will be 4. And forces are given as well. So what we did? With the help of column axial force, we have found out beam shear. With the help of beam shear, we have found out beam moment. Now with the help of beam moment, look, I have placed the respective value of beam moment. We will be finding out the column moments by the summation of moment at particular joint equals to 0. So if I am considering joint A, there are members A to B and A to D. So here are my force, and this is my 16.23 kN into meter. So over here you can find out moment at AD. So joint at A equals to 0, summation of moment at A equals to 0. So if I'm standing over here, 16.23, which is going in anti-clockwise direction, is positive, minus MAD equals to 0. So by keeping MAD on the right hand side, we can find out MAD equals to 16.23 kN into meter. So we have found out for MAD. In the same way, we can find out for joint B. Here member are B2E, B2A and B2C. I have to count. And we can find out for the member BE, MBE. So here it is 16.23 to 23.8 minus MBE. It's going clockwise, and clockwise I have assumed negative. So we can find out MBE. For at the joint C, with the help of it, we can find out MCL. Similarly, for joint D, we can find out MDG. This we have recently found out, and this we have earlier found out, and in the same manner we can find out all the moments of column. So with the help of this column moment, we can find out column shears. So these are my column moment. So divide by column moment divided by half of the distance, we can find out the shear. So let's see, QAD equals to QDA equals to MAD divided by 2. So what is my MAD? This is 16.23 divided by 2, it is coming out to be 8.12 kilonewton. 40.03 divided by 2, 20.01. 23.80 divided by 2, 11.9. Similarly, for all this also we can find out column shear. And not explaining in detail because we have already did this. This is my column shear. Equal and opposite need to be applied at the midspan of the column. So similar way, with the help of shear of column, we can find out X shear for B. So while considering summation of horizontal force equals to 0, so I have to cut this joint A at this point, summation of horizontal force is equals to 0. So on the left hand side I have assumed negative, and the right hand side I have assumed positive. So you can see this maximum load is on right hand side, so I have assumed my axial of the beam in the opposite direction to it. So 40 minus SAB is nothing but axial force of member AB minus 8.12, because it is going in left hand side, so I will consider left hand side as a negative, equals to 0. So SAB is 31.88 kilonewton. As it is towards the joint, so it is compressive. So I have placed over here. Now I have to count the joint B. So 31 is going right hand side, so positive. This is going in left hand side, so negative and negative. So with the help of that, we can find out SBC value. So SBC is in compression because it is towards the joint B. So we have found out for this. Similarly, we can find out for SDE as well as for SEF. So this is my last. We have found out the axial forces in the beam. So first we have found out the axial force in the column. With the help of axial force in column, we have found out beam shear. Then beam shear will help in found out beam moment. With the help of beam moment, we have found out column moment. With the help of column moment, we have found out column shear. And with the help of column shear, we have found out beam axial. So these are my linked steps which help to find out all the forces. After finding out shear, moment and axial forces, we have to draw the diagram. So this is my beam shear, and this purple one is my column shear. So look, this 8.12, this 20.01 and this 11.9 I have drawn in purple one. Similarly for 24.3, 60.03 and 35.3 I have considered as a this way, and for beam shear it is considered in such a way. So assume that this is going up and then down, you can consider any other direction. So we have found out the shear diagram, and for this it is going in right hand direction and it is closing up. So this is my shear force diagram, this is my bending moment diagram, as both are in same direction, so one has to be down and another has to be up. Similar way, this is my beam moment and these are my column moments. So at last, axial force diagram. So we can, with the help of all the forces, we can draw the axial force diagram.